Welcome inside Crystal Ice Arena in Krasnoyarsk here at the 29th Winter University. And it's the final day of competition, but we still have two big hockey games to go. The first one, the bronze medal game, will feature Canada taking on Kazakhstan. You see some of the Canadian fans there getting ready for this one. And that will be followed by the main event. Russia will take on Slovakia for gold here in Krasnoyarsk. My name is Doug McLean. Thanks for tuning in. Canada looking to medal for the seventh straight year. They fell yesterday 5-1 to the host Russians, while Kazakhstan had come into this university at having won three straight silver medals. That streak will end, but they will look to continue their medal streak. They were shut out last night by the upstart Slovakian team. And there you see the road to this bronze medal game. The last time these two teams met in Universiad medal round competition was back in 2013 in Italy in Trentino, Canada winning that gold medal game 6-2 as you see Kazakhstan make their way to the ice. These two teams were in the same preliminary group and played just 3 days ago, with Kazakhstan knocking off Canada 4-3. Anton Nekriach with two goals. Tournament leading scorer Valerie Gurin had two assists in that contest. While for Canada, they were led by Christophe Boivin, who had a goal and two assists. There you see Canadian head coach Kevin Hamlin. We are just about set to go here at Crystal Arena. There you see Kazakhstan head coach Yuri Mihailas. It's a quick turnaround for Kazakhstan. The game, their semifinal last night, ending at about 10 p.m. local time, and they're back at it here at 11 o'clock this morning. There is the starting lineup for Team Canada. Canada will start Dawson McCauley today. There is the starting lineup for Team Kazakhstan. And we are underway. I'm going to make a correction. We were given the wrong information on the starting goaltender. It is Auger for Canada. So just to clarify, what you saw on screen showed that it was McCauley, but it will be Auger in for Canada. So just to make that correction for everybody watching, no matter where you're watching from, we appreciate you tuning in. Canada in white with red and black. Kazakhstan in their nation's colors of light blue and yellow. Big hit there by Liam Mascant for Canada. And LeMay, who scored the only goal for the Canadians in the semifinal, is out on this shift as McFadden lost the puck crossing the Kazakh blue line, and Kazakhstan will now settle it down. Here's Shalapov. Livide for Canada. Fires it to the opposite corner. Stefanenko chips it out, but kept in. Livide right on net. Kudryavtsev had to make the save. Henry knocks it down, and Shestakov now up for Kazakhstan. Yakotnikov couldn't get the shot off. And Canada will wheel back. Dumped in by Henry. Chizowski played it in front. Del Poggio will steal it for Canada. Stefanenko in behind. And now Henry keeps it in, puts it on net, right into the glove of Sergei Kudryavtsev. So just back with Auger, just to confirm in net, his numbers here at the Universiad: 3.45 goals against average and an 881 save percentage for the goaltender from Université de Québec, Trois-Rivières, back in Canada. Now here's Titov. Shot blockered away by Ogier. Canada plays it up to the blue line, but no further. Kept in, Gurkov. Back at the line, Nedraliev right on, and Ogier controls that rebound and will fall on it. Nekriach with a bump on McFadden, who gets a little bit of work on that right shoulder. There you see McFadden still favoring that right arm. Plays for the Acadia Axemen. Atlantic University Sport. First year, 21 points as a first-year player in 30 games with the Axemen. Puck dumped down, and Shalapov wins the race ahead as Ajak. So it will be an icing call against Canada. There's Yuri Mihailas. Shot right on, rebound in front. Chizelski split second late to get it. A battle just to the side of Kudryavtsev. Harper and Shalapov. King comes up with it. He'll play it cross ice. Canada, 2-on-1 right in front. Great pad save. No goal. The puck did cross the line. It's going to be waved off. I think they're going to rule that the pad was pushed in. We'll see if they take a look at this one. Harper asking for a review. Looks like they're going to get it. The puck got right to the line on that quick 2-on-1 that Canada was able to create. You'll see the initial save. That's going to be an interesting call because the puck was loose. As you see Harper right in. And then it's Neal coming in late. Oh, no, he does hit the pad first. I think that's going to be, that'll be confirmed as a no goal. If he'd gotten the puck first, that might have been a different story, but hits the pad, and then the puck goes in after. So I think this will not count, and we will remain at zeros here just past the 10-minute mark. And another look, you see the play by Harper, the puck there, and Neal just takes a stab at it. Not much more he could do, but again, I think this will be confirmed as no goal. And there you have it. So it will remain no score. Nekriach, 1-on-1. Anton Nekriach, and behind the net, wraparound attempt. Puck still loose in front. Canada will come up with it. Wavin shot deflects off the skate of Shalapov into the netting. There is Anton Nekriach. 9 goals to lead the tournament in scoring. He won the Kazakh League goal scoring title back in 2016 with 28 goals. This season had 16 in 43 games with Biberis Astana. Leaves it for Yule. Here's Yule. Back at the blue line. Shot goes wide. Nurgaliev picks up the rebound behind the net. That pass gets by Nikulin. Canada able to keep it in. Delpaggio bumping with Stepanenko. Now back at the blue line. Maskin, his shot blocked. Canada momentarily keeps it in. And now they'll regain control, but they lose it. Gurin to Nikulin. Gurkov up ahead for Kazakhstan. He'll put one right in. Off the logo of the jersey of Sébastien Ogier. Dmitry Gurkov played 19 games in the KHL this year with Baris Astana, no points. Shestakov and Chizowski on the draw. Icing waved off. Chizowski comes up with it in behind the net. He'll play it up ahead. Now it is Chizowski. That will be an icing call. Waved off though. Harper wins it. Chizowski nearly got a stick on that centering pass from Harper. Chizowski plays it over to Del Poggio. Tried to bank that one in off the side of Ogier. Now played back. Plushenko. Ibrivikov, Plushenko, one-timer, deflection in front, still loose. And Titov tried to turn and sweep that one home, but didn't get much on it. Not able to chip it ahead. Thompson, Wallace, that shot high on Kudryantsev, and the puck bounces right back in front, and he'll pounce on it. There you see the deflection right in front. Nice job by Ogier to find it. And then you can see Titov unable to turn around and get a good look at that net. Nice job by Wallace. The back pressure to eliminate that chance. Moments ago on Nurgaliev. Shot just misses. I think Ogier got a pad on it. Back at the blue line, shot does not get on net, and now 2-on-1 for Canada. Boivin and Hanlon. Boivin shot high over top of the net. Played back in front, deflects off the glass, and Nikulin will flip it into center. Hanlon dumps it into the Canadian bench. Canada medalist in 6 straight, 10 of the last 11. Wallace up for Canada. They score! Aiden Wallace as the puck popped free to him. Jack Patterson's initial shot deflected over. And Aiden Wallace, the beneficiary, and he rifled it. Blocker side, top shelf. There you see the initial shot and a perfectly placed snapshot by Aiden Wallace. Right off the post and in. The 1-0 lead. Right in front, Canada with another chance. They score! Daniel Del Poggio picked up the turnover and with a nice move to the forehand, tucks it under the arm of Kudryavtsev, and quickly it's 2-0 Canada. Bad clearing attempt by Kazakhstan ends up right on the stick. Back at the point. Dumped in behind the net by Neal. Nearly turned over again at the faceoff circle. That was Nekriach who almost had his pocket picked. Gurin, oh, nice deflection in front. Yakovlev nearly found the top corner. Dumped out across the blue line, and Kazakhstan will come back in with it. Shestakov. Shot. Right on and held by Ogier. Bit of a similar story to what we saw last night for Kazakhstan. Lots of chances, lots of shots, and there's that great deflection. Looks like Ogier might have gotten a shoulder on it. Now Kazakhstan quickly back into the Canadian zone. Played back. Alexandrov in, shot that one, got through, but deflected just past the post in behind Ogier. LeMay speeds through center. LeMay in front, tried to find Hanlon, but that pass was deflected away, and Kazakhstan back with Presnov. Maskant pushed it in behind his own net. Hanlon gets to center and will dump it in, and Canada will change up the forward group. The gold medal game will follow this. Face-off will go at 3 o'clock in the afternoon local time here in Krasnoyarsk. So we hope you can tune in for that one. That should be a really good game. A Slovakian team that I won't say has been a surprise at this tournament, but maybe a little bit of one. That puck does not stay in. And they were full measure for the 4-0 win last night. They were badly outshot, but really did not give a ton of high quality looks to Kazakhstan. And when you have goaltending like they had from Tomek, certainly you will put yourself in a good position to win most nights. Russia, I thought, really dominated the game against Canada in that 5-1 win. So it'll be a very interesting gold medal game. They met earlier in the tournament before it officially began. Patterson gives chase there. He's bumped in the corner by Gurin. So it's back on March 1st, and Russia defeated Slovakia 2-1 in overtime. Now played up ahead, LeMay in alone. LeMay just over top of the net. Kudryavtsev got a glove on it. Canada have been able to spring free a few times. There's a hit to the top of the circle. LeMay loses the puck just across the blue line, and now Kazakhstan will settle it down. Puck played back as they were making a change. Gurkov forced to come back for it. Alexandrov. Now Gurkov. Alexandrov can't get it in. Gurkov in the corner has Nekriach and Likotnikov in front. Puck comes out, but Zajac will come up with it for Team Canada. Zajac to the wing, shot right on, stopped by Kudryavtsev. Through two periods of play, Kazakhstan led in ice time by a forward, which is a bit unusual, Arkady Shestakov. He's played 14-12 through 40 minutes. Backhanded in, right in front, right to Ogier, and that counts. Kazakhstan on the board, but they're going to go to video review, and I think we're going to have the same discussion we had on the goal that was waved off in the first period for Canada, whether the pad for Ogier was pushed in first. Just an innocent backhand right up to Ogier, and yeah, I don't think that one's going to count. If we go by the same standard they set with the goal that was waved off in the first, I think this one too is going to be waved off. Don't see it from that rebound, but you can't push the pad in to try to get the puck in, and that's exactly what happened. So, of course, with video review, to be honest, you never really know what you're going to get, but you see Team Canada fans saying, nope, we don't think it's a goal. And my suspicion was correct. And the standard that was held in the first is held in the second. And the crowd generally not impressed with that. The Kazakhstan bench obviously not happy, but those fans are pleased. Those are always contentious calls, but you usually know you have it right when the team that has the call go against them doesn't complain a whole lot, and that's happened in both cases, Canada and Kazakhstan. Neither team really argued it a whole lot. I think once they had seen the replay, Battle in the corner. Puck still not moving. Three players each, and now it finally comes up along the boards, and Canada will get it to the Kazakh blue line where Alexandrov will play it across. Turned over, and Hanlon now in behind the net. That's Thompson. Maskant, Rister, right into his teammate Hanlon, who's prone on the ice. Maskant fires it. Kudryavtsev didn't get a clean handle on it initially, but he will hold on to it. Canada keeps it down. They're content to just keep the puck and cycle it in the Kazakh zone. Puck centered, and now Nekriach will come up with it for Kazakhstan. Quickly into Canadian territory, but he's stripped there and up ahead. Here's Fry in alone. He's hauled down. Penalty upcoming. Fry wants a penalty shot. He's not going to get that, but he is going to get the first power play for either team in this hockey game. Behind Thompson, LeMay will sweep it back to Levier. So a hooking penalty for Klashenko. Here's LeMay, shot. Kudryavtsev never saw it, bounces in behind him. Played back, Levier again, shot right on. Good job by Kazakhstan to clear the rebound away from danger, and it heads all the way down the ice. Canada into Kazakh territory. Chizowski can't control it, and Kazakhstan will fire it all the way down. 27 seconds left in the first penalty of the hockey game. Here's Neal. Played back, shot, deflected away. Del Poggio in the corner. Harper has to go and collect his stick as Kazakhstan dumps it down the ice again. And now here at Universiad, Zajac drops it off. Yule puts it on net. Stopped by Kudryavtsev, and here is Gurin. Expect to see a lot of this line over the course of the last 5+ minutes. This top line for Kazakhstan. But then dumps it in. There's a fair amount of snow built up on the ice, so maybe that's causing a bit of issues for both teams right now. McEwen shot right on for Ogier. And now Kudryavtsev back on the bench. 2:13 to go. Canada leading 2-0. Canada now with another chance. Harper holds up and scores. Stephen Harper will cinch it for Canada. Canada will clear, and that does it. Team Canada knocks off Kazakhstan 3-0. And those fans are pretty happy. Canada will win bronze, their 9th all time. My name is Doug McLean. Thanks for having watched this one.